everyone, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm gonna answer a question from the comments. Someone asked, hey, how do you put a like and unlike button in your report? And I got an idea. Stay tuned to see how I did it. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, here's the real question. Tochi from the buttons video that Adam and Amanda did, she said, hey, great video. Supposing I want to add a like and unlike button to a report, but not just that, she wants to know, how do I get the count of number of likes and unlikes? Whew, that's a good question. And I immediately was like, oh, I think I got an idea. And so that's what I'm going to show you in this video, okay? So enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the very first thing I did was open up PowerPoint. You may be like, why are you using PowerPoint? Well, let me show you. So we have this background that we use for our report. And what I did was I inserted a text box and I position the up and down buttons the exact place that I want them. And then I hit Windows, period. And it brought up the emoji window and I typed thumbs and you can see there's a thumbs up. And then I repeated the exact same thing for the thumbs down. And we have a video that talks about using PowerPoint pages as the background. After I did that, I did file, save as, save a copy, and then I changed it to PNG right there. And then I saved the individual one. If you've never seen this before, you should go check out the video. And then I went to my report in Power BI and I set that as the background. So I clicked on the page, went here to the format page, went to canvas background, and I choose it with thumbs up and down. Pretty easy. So then I got it, that up down button. I'm not sure why I didn't persist the colors and I didn't put a whole bunch of work in trying to figure out why, but go check it out and you know what to do, post it in the comments below. So then I just went to home, I pressed enter data, and then I created this table that contained the report name and the page name. So sales, and then for each page I had a row. And then I created two measures. I created a measure that was 0 for down and 1 for up. You can do this however you want, yes, no. So then after I did that, I went out to my OneDrive and I clicked on the little waffle in the top left and I chose SharePoint. And then I went to a library that I created, and in the documents folder, I created a spreadsheet. This is what the spreadsheet looks like. I added some columns, report name, page name, user email, up or down, and the timestamp. And then I made sure to choose it. And then I went to insert and I chose table. And then if I go to table design, I named it ratings. I know a lot of steps, but you don't have to use Excel. You may already know where I'm going, but we'll talk about the different options once I get there. And then once I did that, I was like, all right, now the fun will begin. I went back to Power BI and I chose the Power Automate button. That's right, I'm going to use Power Automate. If you haven't ever worked with the Power Automate button in Power BI, I have a video where I showed you how to get started. You need to go and check out that video. I took all of the fields that I want to pass to that Power Automate and I put it into the Power Automate data field wheel. And so I want the page name, I want the report name, and for this one, this is going to be the down button. So I put the measure for down. For the up one, I put the measure for up. And then the next thing I did was I took the page name and I opened up the filters panel and I drug it here and I locked it because I don't want anyone to switch which page I'm passing in, because when you're using the Power Automate button, it passes whatever the filter value is into it. You could do this different ways if you want to, but I wanted to make it as seamless for my report consumers. So then what I did was I went here and I chose edit, and right inside of Power BI, I start building out my Power Automate flow. And so you can see I built an uprated one. So now I'm going to build a downrated. They didn't have a template for inserting into an Excel table. So I just chose the update one. Make sure you get all authenticated here, choose continue. And right here, I'm going to name this. I'm going to call this down rating, and then I'm going to delete this update. And then I'm going to say new step, and I'm going to choose Excel again. And I was guessing if there's an update, there has to be an add. And sure enough, there's an add row into Excel. So you click the drop down and I put this into my surveys group. That's the location that it's in. Click the drop down. It was in documents. And then if I go right here, click on browse, you can see there's my report rating. And then I choose my table and see, I have my ratings table. So from there, it's going to expand out. And this is where it's so important that you bring the proper fields into that field well. There's some that the Power BI action automatically brings, but if you want to bring some additional fields from your report, you need to add those. Then what I did was I found this right here and I clicked on report name, and and you can see there's report name. I just click it and then click here again. Not sure why that collapsed. And then click in the page name one, and then I chose page name, username, because I want to capture all this information because I want to see who's liking and not liking my reports. And then if I scroll down a little bit, there's my down, and then the timestamp because I want to know when they did it. And then I'm going to choose save, give it a second, and choose save and apply. And then I'm going to go back, choose apply, and then back to my report. And then you'll see all of this. So what I did was I clicked it. I went to the format panes. I said, you know what? I don't want to feel. I went to general. I turned off all the icons. All the titles are turned off. I went to the button text. I got rid of the button text. And I changed the color of the button text to match the background for my report. Because if you don't, you'll see a little arrow there. And then I went to general, to effects, and I turned off the background. Then I took that button. I resized it. And I think I did turn on borders here. You know, I did lots of tinkering to get it the way I wanted it. And so now I have my up and down. You need to make sure that whoever's accessing the report also has access to that flow that I created in Power Automate. And you go watch the other video. I talk about all that. But now if I click this button, I'm in the desktop, so I need to hold down control. But if I click that thumbs down, if I go over to my spreadsheet here, you'll see that Patrick did a thumbs down for sales overview. If I go back and I click the other one, you can see I gave it an up arrow. All right. What do you think? A lot of steps, a lot of tinkering. It's like the art of the possible with Power BI. There's so many ways you can do things, but I'd love to know what you think. I'd love to know if you have any questions or comments. You're coming up with a better way. I bet you the flow people are like, ah, Patrick, we can do this a better way than what you're showing. Well, let me know. You guys know what I like to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.